What instantly makes you attracted to someone? Someone's who's receptive. That playing hard to get stuff is annoying and a turn-off. Show me that you're into me. I love that. Yes, I totally agree. Playing hard to get just me off. If they like me. True though, I used to hook up with a girl I initially didn't think was very attractive or my type at all. One of her friends told me she was super into me. All of a sudden I'm like, gotta get me some of that. It does make you look at people differently. I was going home after a messy night and this guy walking with us kissed me. All I remembered about him the next day was he was a great kisser and awkish looking but not my type. We began texting after and he was keen to meet up, and when I did he was more attractive to me, because of his attention to me maybe. Been together months now. These days he's hot as fck to me lol. Six figures in a heart condition. Oh god. Not that there's anything wrong with it, but I thought you said six fingers. My father was killed by a six-fingered man. Passion. Almost doesn't matter what it's about. When I hear someone get passionate about a hobby or cause, see the twinkle in their eye, I instantly want to be their friend and geek out with them. Monsieur. Same. It's infectious to share in someone else's excitement, especially if it's something I don't know much about. I've picked up many new interests this way. It's even better if they're just as genuinely interested in hearing about my hobbies, so you get that super excitable back and forth going. Confidence and sense of humor. The guy can be 50 pounds overweight or skinnier than me, but if he has these traits, there is a high probability that I will find him attractive. I have confidence. I have tons of humor. Much of my humor tends to be sarcastic and/or self-deprecating, though. Do you really have confidence if your humor is sarcastic and self-deprecating? Not impossible, but sarcasm and self-deprecation are so often signs of insecurity masked with fake confidence. Catching my offbeat references. You have the sickest references. Everybody knows that. Your references are out of control. Freckles usually does it for me. Seeing your comment and the upvotes, it has actually made me feel better about the freckles I have. Thank you. I'm curious, why do you feel bad about your freckles? I really love them. They make a girl so much cuter. Smart. Funny. Quirky. Has to genuine, though. Nothing worse than someone trying to be quirky and unique in order to distract from their dearth of personality. Lol. I'm so random. You mean you have no self-control? When they have greasy skin and lizard-like features, edit. Wow, thanks for the upvotes, guys, and happy Halloween. And they own Facebook. Yeah, they're dollar wheat for dollar ownality. I also love two huge perky brains and a round, plump soul. You're into Siamese twins. Quite frankly, a cute and humble smile and possibly a hidden giggle, but also a bit of a more sarcastic side with the real eating grin, honestly. Eating grin. Eye color. Especially light brown eyes. How about dark brown eyes? Dark brown eyes are my favorite. A girl singing. A girl. A. When girls make fun of me and or boss me around a little, I love that. Get off your winking face. You like that. You. When I was younger, intelligence used to be the biggest draw to me, regardless of appearance. But then I realized how frequently intelligence was paired with arrogance. Basically, I am very smart, but the first time I met my now boyfriend, 2 years ago, I had my first instance of instant attraction. When we made eye contact and he smiled, I could have been knocked over with a feather. Now kindness is the top priority, and I am lucky to be with someone who is not just incredibly kind, but so incredibly intelligent as well, and without the arrogance. I am also amazed every day at how attractive he is. I don't mean to gush. I just love him so much. Heart suit. Ah, that's so cute. Good for you. Snark. Like, if you can be so sarcastic, it's almost infuriating, in a light-hearted sort of way. I'll probably be really into you. Ditto. Ditto squared. For me, nothing is more of a turn-on than someone with a very dark humor, and a good understanding of sarcasm. Yeah. Guys, you should grunt more or do some sexual breathings. I don't know, but chicks dig your voice when you call them in the morning. And GT, guys, you should grunt more or do some sexual breathings. Usually when I do this, I get asked to leave the store. Too much, but aside from appearance, intelligence, humor, and clumsiness. Thought clumsiness was just me lol. I think it's endearing. They are kind to animals. I firmly believe that all animals should be treated with love and kindness. While they may not be able to crunch hard numbers or write a sonnet, they do have souls, and deserve the same chance at happiness as we have. It is for that reason that I always pet a dog when I see one, and make sure my garden is welcoming for the native birds. Username does not check out sad face. Eyes, a look could be game-changing. Nice, round. There's nothing more intoxicating than the clear absence of a. I heard Holt's voice say this quote in my head the instant I saw the thread title. She must be a connoisseur of cheese and have extra long arms. Yes, always go for the long-armed Frenchie, being comfortable in their body. Eek. Now I feel shy. If they're searching for their honor, so, Crown Prince Zuko, bright eyes and a nice smile. Someone that is quick and witty. Someone that says things I've yet to ever hear someone say. I'm married and I always fall deeply in love all over again with my wife when I see her work. She is a middle school orchestra teacher at a low-income school. Those kids don't have much but they have her and she loves them a year. Also she a giant dork and I love it. Hey, do you wanna see my Pokemon card collection? Honestly, yeah. I had this huge crush on a guy and he collected Yu-Gi-Oh! But I collect Pokemon and honestly it felt like a Romeo moment every time we met at the library to teach each other our games. For a card game would play so sweetly if it went by any other name. XD. Take your upvote for such a good comment. Pheromones. I had this major crush on a guy a while ago and all I can remember is wanting to bottle up his scent and smell it forever. Although cologne covered it up eventually. Kindness and wit. I was getting out of bed one morning while my fiancé was able to sleep a few hours longer. She was frustrated I couldn't stay behind with her so she asked me to leave my shirt behind for her to smell. I had an ex that wanted to borrow some of my shirts for this reason. God, I miss her. Humble intellect. The one and only reason I won't date someone is if they're extremely stupid, arrogant, genuine individuality. If I can see that they're not trying to be anyone other than who they really are, it's incredibly endearing. I'm a sarcastic prick. That's just something I've accepted about myself. A girl that can match or even surpass my banter is attractive. Shows me that she not only has a sense of humor, but that she can stand up and is strong-willed. I'm also a sucker for a giggle. Adorable. That smile that usually follows is just, God. Eyes twinkle too. You've got me by this point. If you're cool with me burying my face between your extra points. Maturity. I met my wife when I was 20 and she was 21. On top of her good looks, what really attracted me was that fact that she had direction in her life and wasn't a typical college girl. 10 years later, no regrets, a weird laugh, having an opposite charge to me. It's positively magnetic, I agree. If they show literally a sign of affection or kindness towards me for more than 5 minutes, when they're Danny DeVito, if he is well-spoken and articulate, nice, taken care of hair, when I see a man with good hair that isn't too short or too long and it's all puffy and stuff, I want to touch it and play with it. Curiosity. That spark of what is this? I must find out more. A kind and caring attitude. Someone who isn't judgmental over something I'm trying to fix. I was one of those kids who took shock care of their teeth and I'm extremely self-conscious about it. I've been doing everything I can to fix them with my limited funds and resources, but people still treat me like a disgusting pig despite living a very clean life. If they have compassion. A smile most definitely. Second for me would have to be their personality and if they're a good person. Cleavage. Username CH. Oh, forget it. Looks like the username isn't the only thing that you're checking out. Red hair. Kind smile. Kinder personality. Edit. Also being female lol. A pulse generally does it but it's not a necessity. Ginger hair and cute face. If she has a sweet personality, that'll do me in. It's the honey I like, not the vinegar. Physically, freckles. I don't know when it started, but the last girl I went on a date with had freckles. I also saw either a bartender or a cashier with freckles earlier this month and thought, well, damn it, I find her cute now, being my ex-wife. FML. I've heard lots of stuff like being a family person or having a sense of humor. Maybe long legs or a big or something. Me, I'm a sucker for big words and jargon. Like seriously. If you just speak out loud enough for me to hear and say something like golly gee, that film really didn't do it for me. But the sound design was alright. I really liked the usage of arpeggios in the second quarter before. You can bet your sweet little tush that, despite the fact that I didn't understand a single word that came out of your mouth, I'm like 85% going to be like, that's cute. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious winking face. If they shout tin roof, rusted, when they're straightforward, have a sense of honor, can protect themselves, raise a wit,